Greetings, my name is Elias Vic, and I hope you're all doing well. This will be an episode on the camera map modifier in 3D Studio Max. So what is the camera map modifier? Well, this modifier can be used for many things, and is especially used for post-production video editing and VFX. What it allows you to do is to create a scene in 3D Studio Max from one or multiple still images very quickly. So if you have an image and want to add a custom-made model into that image and render out a video or still footage, this would be a great way of doing it. Now, there are many techniques and rules on how you should use the camera map modifier, and I'm no expert on it, but I will give you a great coverage on the tool so you can fully experiment with it and try it yourself. When it comes to games, there are no good uses for this tool. It's mostly used for images and movie production. Nonetheless, it's always good to know about this modifier. Alright, so I believe that we are ready to get started now. So when you're working with the camera map modifier, we need four things: a camera, an image, a mesh, and some common sense. Now what you want to do is to press the M key on the keyboard to go into the material editor in 3D Studio Max. Then in here you want to drag out a standard material node onto the grid. And then you want to drag in your image. And add that onto the diffused color. After that, you want to click the checker pattern with the light bulb to make it visible in the viewport. Now you want to press Alt B on the keyboard, go to Use Files, and select the background image again. Now you want to click OK, and it's going to be added onto your viewport. Now go up to Perspective in the left corner and click on Show Save Frames. Now on to the tricky part. You want to align your grid onto your background image. This should take some time to do. A trick that I have is to go into your front viewport and then go back to Perspective again to get a straight grid. When that is complete, you want to create a plane in your scene. And what I'll be doing is to cover the entire floor. Now the important thing here is to add a couple of length segments and width segments to make the mesh look better in the end result. Now I'm going to make another plane, and that's going to be the wall piece. Same thing goes for this, I just make the wall piece and align it so that it fits the wall. And also, the same thing applies to here, you want to add a couple of length segments and width segments to make it look better. After this is completed, you want to go ahead and make this into an editable poly and attach both of the pieces together. When that is complete, you want to go ahead and go to the modifier list and apply the camera map modifier. What you want to do now is to go to the toolbar and click on Create, Cameras, and then create Physical Camera from Viewport. Now if we minimize the perspective view and go and check the other views, you can see that we have a camera in here. You now want to select your mesh and click the Pick Camera, and then pick the camera in the other viewport. When that is complete, you can actually go back to the perspective viewport and maximize that again. You then want to apply your texture onto your mesh. If you now take a look at your mesh again, you can see that you have the texture aligned exactly as the viewport background was. This means that the camera is actually projecting your old background image onto your mesh now. If we now take a look in the perspective viewport and jump out of the camera, you can see that it's all messed up in the scene. Everything is everywhere and it's not looking as it should. And you might think, well, how is this really coming together? How come we get this good result in the camera, but it's all messed up in the perspective viewport? And that is the camera map working. It is projecting the map and making it look good from that distance. Now, as I mentioned earlier, I'm not an expert on this, but you get the general idea of how this works, and I hope you learned at least something from this. Alright, I hope you liked the video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Have a nice day, and I'll see you as soon as I can.